If you're Christian and you know that the death is not the end. But today I'd like to speak a little bit about our human condition and this whole relationship with death and with the end, right? So a friend of mine, very dear to me, didn't make it to her 50th birthday. That was yesterday. And I decided to go to see her. I am not the kind of person that goes to cemeteries and stuff like that because I don't believe there is anything physically, but I felt this need to go. And I did, because I always follow my intuition. Interesting enough that I had dreamed with her 2 days prior to that, and she said she was ready, she was okay. And I said, but what do you mean? I'm not, you know, you don't need to do this. And she was, and she somewhat asked me to check on her kids. And so when I went there yesterday, and I saw her name there, it felt like a stamp, like, this is it, it's real. And then I start thinking about, I'm not gonna get into the emotions and feelings of that, but I wanna bring that connection to us and how we perceive life here. How many times we waste so much time in things that have no meaning whatsoever. When you put things in perspective, that this human condition is gonna get to an end, that the body is mortal and it's gonna stop one moment. We don't know when, we don't know how, we don't know why, or, you know, but we know it will happen. So why do we waste all this time in things that don't mean anything? And we compare ourselves to others and we thinking we are better or I'm not as good as, or why, you know, it's gonna happen to all of us that we are gonna get to this point of this flatness of the non-existence of the body and the human condition and all the bonds we make here, all the relationships we developed, all the things we created, all the legacy we built, all the things we've done, they will remain. All the memories. I always like to ask this question. How do you want to be remembered? This is such a deep, profound question here. We often don't think of that in our daily basis. If today was the last day, am I living this day its fullest? Like, am I telling people how much I love them? Am I hugging them enough? And am I showing up as my higher version, my most divine self, as the person that I want to be, that I see myself as, that when I am fully enlightened and dedicated and intentionally working on purpose, how do I show up every day to my loved ones? This thing about self-control, as human beings, we experience that often, you know, or maybe sometimes for some, or rarely for a few. But what is this thing that makes us lose control of ourselves? Like parents spanking kids, I was my whole life until I was 18. I'm not judging or condemning my parents or anything like that, my father, but we do that sometimes. We lose control. I think the magic here is to realize when it's happening and how we respond. Because we know the body is just the instrument of the mind. If you allow the body go crazy, we start doing things, throwing things, yelling at people and stuff, doing stuff like that. I had the situation. I was just playing a silly game and I got so upset. And I realized this is all mine. I am so upset. And then I brought myself back, and it was very good that I had this awareness that I was so upset. I just walked away. And then I went outside, sat at the sun, and I watched the sun set. And I was just thinking about how crazy is that, that stuff happens and we just get into the wave and start surfing it and we have no control whatsoever. So what a blessing is this awareness that we can change the outcome. We can define how we want things to be instead of just let or allow these feelings take over you and do something that you are going to regret. That it's going to hurt somebody. You're going to say something you shouldn't. You're going to be upset about it later. So I just want to bring this awareness here that we're here. We are still here. We are alive. I read a quote the other day that said, there is nothing more daunting than a blank or more exciting than a blank page. Because we can do everything, anything we want. You want to color, you want to write, you want to fold, you want to, whatever you want to do with it, you can do it. That's how I see every day. When I open my eyes, when I wake up, this is a brand new opportunity. Today, right now, this moment you're listening to this, this new awareness that you can start over every day, right? Maybe you're not very proud of yesterday or this morning or earlier today or 10 years ago, but today, right now, you can change this because you still can. You're still here. You can still make the decisions. You can still be the person you want to be. You can still work on that version. You can still polish to become this diamond that you are. You can still work on yourself. You can still develop. You can still learn. You can still become all those things because you're still here. We're still alive. There is still life right here and right here and right here. And that is such a blessing to realize that, you know, we have lived our life up to now, but we can change. We can create a new thing. We can start something. We can modify everything because we are still here. Do you get it? The blessing this is. People, they are there where I went yesterday. There is nothing. Nothing, absolutely nothing they can do about anything anymore here in this dimension. But we're here still in this human experience. We're still meeting people. We're still having challenges. We're still learning. We're still growing. We're still experiencing the sunrise, the sunset, relationships. We're still having this love with the animals. We still experience the seasons. We're still going through so much, and there is a blessing, trust me. Because there's going to be a day that we want. So this is why I am so touched by this name that I chose for my brand, Live Fully Today. If not now, when? Because there's going to be a time that it's going to be it, you know? I always love this analogy that if you have kids, if you're a mother, or you were a kid once, and you probably had this experience that you were brought to an amusement park, maybe Disney, maybe somewhere else, it doesn't matter. But you were there, you had the time of your life, you enjoyed, you played, you went to the games, to the rides, and you wanna had a cotton candy and ice cream and popcorn, whatever, or maybe provide all this to your kids and brought you so much joy to see their happiness. They're living fully the moment, being fully present, and you're there with them, experience all that together, there. Fully. What a blessing that is. But you know, we don't do that often, right? And I feel like our celestial father aims exactly the same thing for us. They want us to be here like this was this amusement park for us to experience life at its fullest, to do it all, to be it all, to live life on our own terms, perfectly the way it should be for me. That I can be all that I can be my own way, that I can become all this, you know, this child that just is so pure and it's so natural, it's so genuine, it's so fully present and do it all and with intention and with intensity and with this passion. And I feel like that's how he wants us to be here. Why we are alive, as we're living here, as we're passing by. You may say, I saw once this, I was in Atlanta airport, and I saw this thing in the wall. It really touched me because it said, just passing by, aren't we all? After all, how do you want to be remembered for the ones that stay? Live it fully today, because today it's all we got. And that's truly a blessing and an honor to be granted this present. Enjoy it. You deserve it.